This is a live event. I'm here at Passion to Profit. I've got a room of, Sean, I think we have 200 plus.
That's correct, Joe.
Today we had more people show up than on the first day, which is unheard of. So, tying the tie. Obviously, the bulk of the tie is going to be on the right side. The quality of the tie is mission critical. I wear a Stefano Ricci tie. And these ties are probably $350 US. Can I do the same thing with a cheaper tie? Absolutely. In fact, yesterday I was wearing a tie that was $3 that I bought in Thailand. It's not about the cost. It's about how it ties a knot. So, first of all, I'm going to button up the shirt entirely. Now, the quality of the shirt you wear is also very important. It needs to fit in your neck well. You should be able to put your forefinger in the neckline. And when you first buy the shirt, you should be able to put two fingers in the neckline comfortably. The dry cleaner or the laundry, and I launder my dress shirts, I don't dry clean them, they're going to reduce the neckline over the first three washings to one finger, okay? It needs to fit correctly. That's real important. When I put the tie in, I make sure it's riding on the inside of the collar. That's important. Yeah. So when I pinch here, here's the knot, bulk, three fingers between the base architecture of the tie. I'm going to wrap it here, and as I bring the wrap around, it forces it to start to, I pinch it there. I go one turn tight. Do you see how it's holding the pinch?
Mm-hmm.
Right? It's holding it because I wrapped tight. Now, I pick up on a thumb and I'm going to engage it tight. So when I push this through there, I want it to be tight. And that's why the silk needs to be a good quality. Now, I do not tighten it. I make sure that I have a break in the tie. So I'm going to control how the knot cinches down. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Can you see that it's clean? It's very clean, right?
Very clean.
It's because of the way it's formed underneath it. It's the infrastructure. So there we have it. And I continue forming it, twisting it. And now I begin to pull it up. I push the bulk underneath the collar, which is mission critical. And I want you to see the length here. I nailed it. If I didn't, I'm going to redo it. A little long. See that? Does it bother me? Yeah, it bothers me. So I'm going to redo it. Now, I want you to see this, and I don't want to redo it. I will not wear it if it's not right. So just that much is going to make a difference. I'm going to add about a half a finger, because that's going to bring it. I already know what the measurement is. I bring it around. I make the pinch. I wrap it. I bring it through. I put the thumb in. And now I'm going to poke it through that chamber that's very tight. And now I'm not going to pull it or do anything until I manipulate like clay, until I model the configuration of the tie. I'm watching my timing because I've got an event here. And so this becomes a bonus training. It's coming out beautiful now. I can feel it. And the length is friggin' perfect. So it's so worth it. Sometimes I do it 6 or 8 times. I mean, if I'm having a really bad day, sometimes I have to do it a couple times. I feel lost myself. So here we go. Now, I want to tighten the knot. So you see, I want to tighten the knot. I want to tighten it so there's no gap. I want it to be friggin' perfect. You see how I'm starting to get that bow? And that's what you're wondering how I did.
Yeah.
Like, how do I get the life of the tie? So that I can see whether the knot is perfect. Almost. Perfect is when it's absolutely centered. Matthew, I'm almost there. There it is. Does that look pretty spot on?
Extremely.
Right? And that's the frame. Enjoy.